Yes, assessable value and customs duty related problem we are going to work out today, where both the things are covered, assessable value and customs duty payable. Both the items are asked. So we are supposed to solve both the things, and based on the information given, we are supposed to consider. Now, assessable value is a total of all the expenses which will be incurred in producing a product and to bring the product to India. So we are going to see what are the different parts of assessable value, what the out of these given things, what items we are supposed to consider, which we can leave. So all those things we are going to see, and we are solving a particular problem. This particular problem, see here, certain information is given. By considering those information, we are supposed to solve this. Now, first concept is cost of the machine imported. Cost of the machine imported, information is given in dollars, $40,000. Packing charges, so whether we have to add packing charges, we have to consider packing charges. Commission to broker on the cost of the machine, so cost of the machine is here, so we have to multiply based on that particular amount. So cost of the machine on that 5%, not on the assessable value, on the cost of the machine. Design and development charges incurred outside India, so we are considering this. So all items almost till now, yeah, all these items we are going to consider. Next one is technical fees. Definitely we are supposed to consider technical fees. Technical fees is a must, we are considering. Sea freight charges, clearly it is given as sea freight charges. When it is sea freight charges, when amount is given, directly we are going to write the amount. There are not at all any adjustments. Insurance also given in the problem, so that amount itself we are writing. If it is not given, then we are writing 20% of FOB price. Here 1.125% of FOB price. But when it is air freight, both the amounts we are comparing, the amounts given as well as 20% of FOB, whichever is less will be considered. Next, material supplied by importer, 1,50,000 is given. So importer has supplied and it is used in the product, so we are adding this to the assessable value. Transportation charges and insurance premium from port to factory. Port to factory means from Indian port to his workplace. So in this play, whatever expenses will be incurred for this purpose won't be considered at all. So this 60,000 we are not going to consider because it is incurred in India. Yes. Next, other information, BCD is given 12.5%, IGST is given, safeguard duty is there. Yeah, social welfare surcharge is not given, that we are supposed to see. Compensation says 25% is given. Exchange rate, only one amount is given. When in the problem only one amount is there, we need not compare and we need not worry. All that amount itself we have to consider. So that is the thing. We'll see the solution. Pause the video and write the problem. So assessable value computation. So two amount columns. You better to write the exchange rate here. Exchange rate we are supposed to write always. We'll see the concept. Cost of the machine, it is given here in the problem, 40,000, which is multiplied by rupees 65. So this amount you will get. Then the items, almost all the items we are supposed to add except one item, that is the transportation charges and insurance premium from port to factory. The bitter all item consumer like D problem only. So packing charges, commission, design and development, technical fees, material supplied by importer. See, material supplied by the importer, it is given in rupees. In that case, there is no confusion. We need not convert it or nothing we have to do. So we'll leave the first column blank and we'll write it in Indian rupee column because it is clearly given there. Next, FOB price we are supposed to consider here. FOB price, because the total of all these amounts, 34,97,000, is our FOB price. So on this FOB price we are supposed to consider freight and insurance if the information is not available. But in this case information is available. 4,000 is freight charges, insurance is 3,000. So 20% concept won't come at all when it's air freight. In that case, given and 20% we are comparing, lowest we are writing. So when you do the total of all these items, you'll get 39,52,500. So that amount will be your assessable value. So pause the video and write the problem. Assessable value is not enough for us because we have been asked to calculate customs duty payable. So customs duty also we are going to consider here. You may have forgot the procedure, so I'll remind it again. On assessable value, BCD will be calculated, then NCCD if it is given, then CVD if it is given. So you will do the total on that basis. You will calculate social welfare surcharge. If it is given, that given rate we will consider. If it is not given, 10% flat we will consider. Then safeguard duty, anti-dumping duty, protective duty, these will be calculated on assessable value. Then two taxes will remain, IGST and compensation cess. So these things we have to consider. We'll see to the solution. Before that, pause the video and write down this solution. So this will be our calculation of customs duty calculation. We'll see assessable value. This is the amount which is available. It is given to us. After calculating assessable value, we got that amount. To this value, we are going to consider 12.5% on this value. That is basic customs duty given in the problem. So both the amounts are totaled here. There is no NCCD, there is no CVD. Then on this amount, we are social welfare surcharge we are going to consider. That means only on the basic customs duty amount, on that amount 10% will be calculated. Safeguard duty and assessable duty will be safeguard duty will be calculated on assessable value. That means on 39,52,000 it will be calculated at 10%, yes, whereas any other items won't come. Then two types of taxes will remain. One is IGST, other one is compensation cess. So IGST will be calculated at 12%, compensation cess will be calculated at 25%. So the amount what we have to consider is, that is total of B. So this amount we are going to consider to levy 12% of the IGST as well as 25% of compensation cess. So these are the things what you have to remember. If you have any doubts, you can ask. These kind of problems you can expect for section C, full fledged problem, where assessable value, customs duty, both will be asked. Thank you.